Hey guys, who doesn't love a classic mac and cheese? There is something about this dish that is so comforting and delicious. But I'm gonna show you how to dress it up a bit and make it perfect for entertaining by using some of my favorite Italian flavors. I love to serve comfort food for a dinner party, especially if you're inviting a group of friends that don't know each other very well. It immediately puts people at ease and makes them feel at home. I also like to serve comfort food like this in something more sophisticated like individual casseroles. That way, it just makes everybody feel a little bit more elegant and special. Now traditionally, mac and cheese is made with little macaroni pasta, and that's good too if you have that on hand. But if you're gonna go out and buy some pasta, you may wanna look for the little mini shells. I love to use the mini shells in something like this because it just makes the dish feel a little bit more fancy. Go ahead and follow the instructions on the back of the box for cooking your pasta. And meanwhile, we're gonna get on with prepping our onions. So in a large saute pan, you're going to add some olive oil, and then you're going to saute up some diced red onion. You can go ahead and season with a little bit of salt and pepper, and just continue to cook them until they're translucent and slightly caramelized. At this point, we're going to add some diced portobello mushrooms. I love the portobello mushrooms because they have a wonderful earthy taste to them. They also just are a little bit more sophisticated than the regular white button mushrooms. But really, either one will work. Go ahead and cook the mushrooms just until they start to release their juices, and then you can transfer this mixture into a small bowl. At this point, go ahead and add a little bit more olive oil if you need to, and then we're going to cook our Italian sausage. So you want to make sure you take the sausage and remove it out of the casing. That's easy to do with just a sharp knife. And then go ahead and cook it until it's cooked through and crumbly. Once the sausage is done, go ahead and transfer it with a slotted spoon onto a plate lined with paper towel. You just want to drain off some of the excess grease. At this point, you do want to wash out your pan because we're going to start to make our bechamel cheese sauce. Go ahead and melt some butter just until it's nice and foamy. At that point, you're going to add your flour. Go ahead and whisk just until a nice paste forms. Then you're slowly going to add your milk, whisking all the while just until you get a nice sauce. And then at this point, you're going to season with some salt and pepper and some freshly grated nutmeg. Then you're going to add about half a cup of cheese. You just want to stir it until the cheese is completely melted, and then you're going to take it off the flame. At this point, you can go ahead and drain your pasta, put the pasta back into your pot, then you're going to add your cheese sauce, and your veggies, and your sausage. Go ahead and mix that all up just until everything is combined. And then I like to transfer this mixture into these little cast iron casseroles that I have. I love these dishes because they make the mac and cheese feel very homey, but sort of elegant at the same time. But any gratin dish will do. You just want to make sure that the dish you choose is actually oven safe. Then you're going to top each dish with about 2 tablespoons of cheese, a sprinkling of paprika, and your breadcrumb mixture. You're gonna put them on a cookie sheet and then pop under the broiler just until that cheese melts and starts to bubble and those breadcrumbs turn golden brown. And then when they come out of the oven, I like to serve them on a dinner plate because these dishes, remember, will be pretty hot having sat under the broiler. Then I just like to finish them off with a little garnish of flat leaf parsley. And because this dish is pretty rich, I also like to serve these with a nice tossed salad. I love this dish because it's easy to put together. It's comforting and familiar, but both sophisticated and elegant. I hope you guys give this one a try and let me know what you think. And I'll see you here next time.